Scott Habermel says, how would you address normal TSH but low T4? The first thing I'd do is I'd look at your T3. So for those of you who aren't familiar with thyroid hormones, so TSH tells your thyroid to make thyroid hormone. T4 is the precursor. T3 is the active hormone. So your T4, so if your TSH is normal, that means that your thyroid gland is receiving the proper messages from your pituitary. But if your T4 is low, I would look, first of all, is your T3 normal or high? So if your T3 is high, then you're probably just converting it very rapidly. If your T3 is low, then even though your pituitary appears to be receiving the right signals, you're not making enough thyroid hormone. And in fact, it would become unclear whether your pituitary is actually making the right signals, because if your T4 and your T3 are low, your TSH should be high, because your pituitary should be saying, wait a second, T4 and T3 are low, so I need to make more of the message TSH to tell the thyroid gland to kick into gear. So if the T4 and T3 are both on the lowish side and the TSH is normal, I would reinterpret the TSH and say, actually, your TSH is not as high as it should be given your thyroid hormones. And so I would then look to the pituitary. In terms of nutritional issues, I think the big things that you're looking at are calories, carbohydrate, and body fat, because the pituitary is overwhelmingly asking the question, do I have enough energy in the short term and the long term to engage in the health promoting long term investments that thyroid hormone governs? And those are many, like all the biological peacocking, like making nice hair and making nice skin and making things look nice. But they're also like protecting your tissues from damage. And then the big, big, big thing, if you're in the right age bracket, is fertility. So if your pituitary is not making as much TSH as it should, then that's basically saying your brain perceives that you don't have enough energy on hand. And that means you're either, your body fat's too low, or your calories are too low, or your carbs are too low, because those are the big signals that your brain's going to use. And then I would say, you know, I mentioned in the nutrition and neuroscience series, I mentioned that all of the releasing hormones, so all of the things that the brain is making to govern the endocrine system, all of them require copper, vitamin C, zinc, and glycine to make. So the other, so I think the big thing to look at is body fat, calories, and carbs. But the next layer to peel back would be those four, vitamin C and copper, especially in the background, zinc and glycine. And I would especially look at those if the big picture incorporates all the other things you expect from those nutrients being missing in the brain. And that's like, it's not just low thyroid, it's low thyroid paralleled with low adrenal, low sex hormones. So across the board, if that's true, yes. And then also, if your appetite is dysregulated, you're eating too much, if your hair is graying, if you're peeing too much, and I might be missing a couple things in there. But if that general picture starts to look like that, that's when I start saying maybe these nutrients are missing in the brain. But always, first thing is carbs, calories, and body fat.